should be live in a few seconds. See if we can pick up. See if we can
Twitch get automatically. As I say, Twitch automatically bumps everybody who's looking at it online, I think, when it goes live.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right.
There it goes.
Wubba lubba dub, he's in.
Alright, and we're live. Speaking of that feedback, oh, that's not feedback. I guess everybody's supposed to be able to hear me.
Yes, that's right. Is that a problem?
No, the delay is just going to be confusing to parse.
Oh, you don't have to listen to the Twitch stream. I just wanted to check it to make sure you're audible to start with. I just turned
on. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm hearing myself, but I'm going to mute myself, so.
Okay, well, you can do that, or...
I'm gonna have to mute the Twitch stream if I'm gonna talk because.
Yeah, that's what I do. I mean, like, there's no sense in listening to the Twitch stream.
Oh God, I just got this weird. That's. It would be probably beneficial to have one person at least, not talking
remotely.
And listening to the Twitch stream.
Yeah, that's what we're gonna have.
And giving feedback.
Let me check the page and make sure we're streaming and everything. And Twitter. Isn't it supposed to, like, Twitch overlay favorited? Okay, yeah. So it did just do a stream update on Twitter, but it didn't do one on Facebook, so. Okay, looks like we got five in, all of which are us.
is Firestar 1215 one of us?
That's Kara, yeah.
Oh, okay. Nice, this is the greatest circle jerk of all time, then.
It starts that way for a sec. Yeah, I'm just gonna. I guess just start playing a little bit and then we'll see what we get.
Don't worry, Kara. I won't reveal your secret identity. Oh, crap. Sorry about that.
Gonna try to play. See if I can play with these controls, with this control scheme, and then try to change it to the controllers. Whoa!
I don't know how I'm supposed to code with like 19 different chat windows open.
Yeah, I know.
I want to watch you play Minigolf for a while, though. I haven't seen it in a long time.
Yeah, it's the new directional aim stuff is good.
Whoa! It's really dark.
Oh, weird. The scan lines and stuff look kind of bad in the stream.
Yeah, that must be weird. Well, I mean, that makes sense.
Yeah.
No matter how you're running it, it,
Tanner Herbert. Climbing glitch, it looks like.
That shotgun reminds me of that, that salt gun that they sell to kill flies with.
Oh, yeah?
Have you seen that?
No, I haven't seen it.
You put table salt in it, and you just kind of pump it with air, and it just shoots a bunch of table salt, and it's supposed to be really good at killing flies. That's what that shotgun looks like.
Hacker's coming. Man, they're blasting me through the cover. Oh, you start to, like, gray out. The scan line effect and stuff gets worse as your suit integrity declines.
Whoa. That screen skewing is trippy.
The screen what?
Skewing, like tilting left or right.
Oh yeah, I know. It like it tilts the screen, but then also it's Man, I need to connect a few more devices, I think, to move us up in the list. Although it does say there's 9 in here right now.
Oh, here, I can connect one right now.
Jinzilla, whoa, cool game, bro. Wanna play that game? Nice. James the Tank Robinson. I'm supposed to apprehend Herbert Tanner. Oh, I've got a kick now. That's cool. If you're moving like forward and then do your sub attack, it's like a kick.
Dude, I can't even find us in a search.
It might take a while to index.
Yeah, like
game development is the game development is what you look for. There's Herbert Tanner right there. He's a shotgun guy too. Man, died so many times. Oh, nice! The knockback, man. Legit. I don't think I have any melee weapons. Alright, I took him out. Non-lethal. Yeah, motion sick. There is a lot of, like, movement. Camera movement and stuff. It's really visible. Alright, the area is secure, so now I gotta get back to the cop car. I'm so slow now, man. You used to start out so much faster. I have to get used to this. Yeah, that is definitely true. If you're the one that's inputting the controls, you know, it's a lot easier on you. Nice little readout from Minifact HQ here. I got a point bonus for finishing the task. So I got some requisition points. I'm going to go back to HQ here and load up. Repair some of my suit integrity. Let's see what we got here. Riot shot. High velocity beanbag. Can't afford it. It's a little bit hard to read the RQ there, but I think I can manage it. Let's see what we got here. Oh, it's 200 points. It makes me kind of want to hollow point, though. It makes me want to save my points up and see what we get. Stomp your couch. There we go.
That's me.
Oh, nice. Rubber rounds. Standard issue mini law riot rounds. I'll take that. Now, what are these, though? Some upgrades we see. Optic sensors. Range detection gear let you identify perks from farther away. Could be useful. I wanted to simulate the sensation of hurling your body through the air, so if you puke a little, it's working. It works well. I get that feeling for sure. Painkiller injector situated directly in the brainstem give users a chance to shrug off lethal wounds, increases organic pain resistance and metagel adhesion. 135. Oh, I've only got 50 points. So I don't have any choice but to back out. Now, how do I get to install this stuff? Ah, there we go. Enter. Oh, nice, man. The new upgrade window is... I mean, the stats window is great, dude. What's this here? Some stats over here for your skill levels. Nice. Can swap through it with the scroll wheel. I kind of want to buy some of these upgrades, but I only have 50 points. But it's only 10 points to upgrade. Just feel like endurance needs a hit. Nice little stat readout on the side. Ooh, okay, 2 points in there. Should keep me going. Now, what about my weapons, my special rounds? PC shot shell or rubber rounds? Oh, I definitely want razor. Oh, it's a replacement for razor rounds. Oh, I see. So when you highlight it, it shows you the ammo type that it would be replacing. So PC shot shell is like a secondary special ammo. This one's your core ammo, so. So this one can you take out non-lethal force, so I'm gonna switch to it. Okay, now let's see. Looks like there's crime in the vicinity here. 5.28 happiness. Let's drive over there and check it out. Okay, I got rubber rounds now, so what is this? I'm just bombarded immediately. Rubber rounds aren't cutting it. Gotta get some better cover. Nope. Jordan Dodge is my target. My TV just both of my displays just crashed, so I can't see anything right now. I can hear I can still hear the input, but both of my displays are totally down. I don't know what it's showing on the stream.
You got flooded with porn immediately.
What's that?
You got flooded with porn almost immediately.
Almost immediately.
You got your screens mixed up.
QTL.
Ministry of Law. Ministry of Law.
Oh, nice. Oh, I see. So it shows the range, too.
Reach for the sky.
Reach for the
sky. Alive.
Oh, that is awesome. That is really good.
Jeff, man, you don't want to have built-in microphone support, so you just yell at your microphone and that's what causes you to yell?
The hacker is messing with my head, dude. So wait, that was non-lethal, right? Oh, no!
Hands behind your head. Come quietly. Never alive.
All right. So that's the key. That's the optimal response right here, right? Everybody down on the ground, subdued and alive. That's like the most. You get the most requisition points for this outcome, correct? Don't taste me, bro. Yeah, you consider yourself. Completely tased. Yeah, the voice is awesome.
You are under arrest.
You are under arrest. Oh man, these hackers, man. Oh, they're hacking me. Oh my gosh, dude. The signal jamming is intense. It is very seasick inducing. Get on the ground. Wow, I am like fully jammed right now. I gotta say, I'm loving the rubber bullets, though.
On the ground. Your move.
Your move. I love the rubber bullets. Oh! I just killed somebody with one. Oh, I killed this guy, too. So they can still die with the rubber bullets if they're already, like, low health or low stamina or something like that. Suit integrity is so low right now. Yeah, that it does. Still, I love the rubber rounds, though. I mean, that was Lawrence Jones. You can still take them down, you know, a lot quicker without really having to worry about... Yeah, just like that.
Let us talk like gentlemen.
The voice, man. Great. There's Alan Dodds. Where's your brother Jordan? I need to talk to him.
Your move. This is the law.
I'm about to die. So close to being dead. I think that's it for me. Oh, man. Deceased. It was a good run, though. I can almost never get past two encounters, man. Let's see how I did. $175 total. That was terrible. 89% apprehension rate, though. Let's get the music back in here. Does it come back? And we have to wait for another screen change or something. I think. All right, got crimes in progress. All right, I'm gonna switch to the control scheme on this. See how playable it is with it. So what is that? Control toggle? Yeah, there we go. Alright, so I got this controller now, so I use the stick to aim. I hear some of Will's music. Okay, I forgot my controls now. I use the right trigger to go into aim mode, and then the right bumper to go into fire. So it's pretty straightforward. Alright, I'm gonna try out some of these melee moves too. So let me get a hang of them here. So
what?
Okay, so main hand. That's my offhand. So if I get a dash going, oh sweet, yeah. Run, and then I did the kick earlier. Dash plus melee. Oh nice. Oh god. What have I done? Oh no, this is bad. Oh my gosh, this is chaos. So much flashing going on right now. Can't hardly see things. Okay, it clears up. So over time, it returns you back to normal. So it's like just a little bit of intensity. Okay. Whoa! Man, the hackers are really intense. Good solid kick in the pants ought to do it for you. Oh, it's really hard to pay it to like pace. Pace that dash kick out. I think I might just shoot them. Ah, what's the deal? Oh, man, they're really unforgiving. Now I'm like trying to get readjusted to the control scheme. So it looks like there was a objective that I failed, or there wasn't one. There wasn't an apprehended objective in the first place here. Either way, looks like I'm just out to annihilate as many bad dudes as I can. The aiming is still pretty straightforward. With the controller, so. Not really a big break between using mouse and keyboard and using a controller. I usually can't even make it past the opening area without. I can't even make it past the second one. I better try and load up really what I should have done is skip the buying, skip mini law HQ and just like spent my requisition points on upgrading my endurance, I bet. Electroshock taser knuckles. Well, I definitely gotta try that. T-Fist goes in there. Runs off of suit power. Now if I can figure out what the button is. Whoa, lower body disappeared for a second. Hacked and shot at the same time, so war were declared. Okay, cool. I see it. So you go to aim, and then your melee attack. Well, it's like a little shocker. Oh, nice. Good non-lethal takedown, kind of like a Deus Ex stun gun type of thing.
Come quietly. Come quietly.
Neat effect on the shouting thing. T-Fist, man, it takes him down. Ah! Ah! Come on. Ah, it's brutal, man. Brutal stuff. What do you think, Jeff? One more run? Chancer Zero. Oh man, it is hard. Well, I think we need to try another run here, see if we can get it done. Alright. Also bear in mind, man, I haven't played this game very much at all, so I'm like trying to figure out the whole strategic, you know, movement here. And I have a tendency to just kind of run in and start shooting, but it looks like it really has more in mind of a slow kind of, you know, picking your shots type of a progression to it, which is something I'm going to have to adjust to. Looks like it might be a little bit of a skill check for new players, but you learn it quite, you know, really quickly. Like, it's a very unforgiving, you know, procedurally generated type of experience. Similar to a Spelunky or a Faster Than Light or something like that. So you learn quite quickly that the world is very unforgiving, and you gotta come prepared. You know, that encounter wasn't so bad. Have a little bit of trouble reaching up and grabbing these ledges when they're right above each other, I notice. For those of you who don't know, the user Stuart Hugh, let me go ahead and make him a mod here. Is the creator of Minilaw, and he's the director of the project here. So he's been the one ramrodding the whole thing and making sure everybody is contributing, the ones that are working on it, and doing a great job so far. It's come a long way. Only 10 points. Man, those lethal takedowns are pretty much no good for anything then, huh? Nevin Tasker. Fat hacker guys, man, they're brutal. There I go again, just running down to jump in. Immediately I'm getting fried by the hackers. Yes, brain fried. Now I need to upgrade to be able to see these guys from here. gosh.
Reach for the sky.
I've gone back to
like gentlemen.
I've gone back to mouse and keyboard controls. I'm liking them a little bit more now that the reticle is like this. It's actually a little bit more straightforward than it used to be. And when we first started this project, it was kind of more of a left and right shooter. So, you didn't really have to worry about using the mouse at all, but now you've got this mouse and keyboard thing, it adds a little bit of extra, you know, component to it whenever you've got a controller, because you got to worry about the sticks and where you're aiming and stuff now, too. But the feel to it is really good. I mean, I think I like the camera viscera and the whole feel to it, and everything is really good. The lore and all this stuff that reads out to you as you play it is just really, really immersive in my opinion. Alright, let's see here. I'm going to upgrade my defense this time. Not messing around, man. I need to be able to survive a little bit longer. Alright. One of the different areas. I don't like the hacker guys, man. They really mess my vision up. Cover didn't grab the cover object, didn't find the ground on that one. I don't know if I killed the target or if I just I probably killed him. I'm just kind of shooting everyone I see, so. Man, suit integrity so low already. Oh man, there's still one more. Somewhere. Oh, two more. Oh, I'm out of bullets though. Better use my shotgun shells. Oh! The blind fire. I took him down after blind fire. Get on the ground.
Hands behind your head. You are under arrest.
I love the voice, man. So good. Secured the area with a... I killed every single person. And then the last guy, I was like, alright, get down on the ground. Those of you who are just jumping in here, this is Minilaw. It's a new project that our art director here, Jeff, the user Stuart Hugh that you see there, he's spearheading the whole project. This is a new one that we're going to be trying to take to market before too long. Yeah. That's fine. Yeah, you know what? You don't have to watch it. Stephen Hawking is a cyborg.
Hands behind your head. Let us talk like gentlemen.
The revenge of Hawking. It's like after he gets a robo suit, comes back. Yeah. There's a lot of stuff, you know, we need to work on still. Definitely. I mean, this will be a good thing though. Like, we do some of these things and, you know, possibly get a demo build out and see what people have to say and take some feedback, you know, from people how we can improve on it. And I'm watching the stream monitor here, and it's, you know, it's the stream monitor isn't really doing it justice, you know, how good the scan line effects and stuff look because of the frame rate kind of drop and everything. And there's a few other things that, like, once it starts to mess up, it does mess with you when you're in the middle of the jamming and stuff. But it actually looks a lot better on the actual screen than it does on the stream window. So, man, great adjustment, Jeff, to the suit integrity buff. Man, that was something that I just could not get past. Nice Wolf. That feels like a good amount. Like, if you're going to spend all the points that you got from the last encounter, that definitely feels like a good thing. I don't know, maybe it's too baby for you, but it's just right for me. Now, I need to try some more of these non-lethal takedown tactics. I want to run in and try them, but I don't want to get killed. So, what's my go-to here? I'm not going to shoot him. I went full auto. I figure this will probably be the last run on Mini Law for now, and then I'll go back to working on 11 Terra, and we can pull out some of the new stuff that we were working on this week, and then do some actual dev on that. But you know, we can start cycling Mini Law into our whole dev process, as far as our, you know, stream and stuff are concerned. I think a lot of people will be interested in seeing it, you know, moving forward. I think, at least. Who just joined the hangout here? Somebody just now popped in the hangout.
Gary did.
Gary?
Yep.
Oh no, dude, I'm Dirty Harry all the way when I play this game, man. It's the only way I can make it. This is good. I feel like I'm kind of getting making some progress now for the first time. I usually don't. Okay, so my car is out of range, and I can only drive to the block. It's within range, so when I progress, the days go by, the time moves forward, and then I get more crimes pop up here. Never even cycled.
This is not a negotiation.
I say it now that he's dead. So what happens if you shout to him, you know, before they've... Oh, sometimes so sometimes you can just talk them down without even having to shoot them at all, huh? One thing I've learned quickly is that bullets move faster than fists. I go in and try to attack them, and they almost immediately shoot me every time. Oh man, I don't have a chance against these guys. What's my strategy here? These guys are running after me. I pretty much have no choice but to open fire. Well, at least I still haven't killed the target yet, so.
Ministry of Law.
Man. Brutal. Brutal out there, though, man. They start shooting you. If you don't have those rubber bullets or something, you don't have the electric fist or something like that, you're really left out to dry. Pretty much have no choice but to take them down. So I pretty much have no suit integrity now, so if I want to actually apprehend anybody, I've got to... Oh, no! Oh, I'm totally done for. How am I supposed to get back at that? It's the only way that... I can't believe the subject is still at large. There he is! There he is. Oh my gosh, this is not going to work. I don't know how to dash on the keyboard. Pistol whip. Pistol whip to death. Kick! Kick him down! Got him!
Drop your weapons.
Alright, I got the target. kick. I love the kick, Jeff. It's great. The kick is top notch. That sets it apart, man. That makes the melee experience worthwhile, in my opinion. The fact that you can do that knockdown kick under the right circumstances. It adds a lot to it, I think. The lighting effects, man, they look really good in here. I like these little fluorescent lights and stuff. It's just me and you, pal. And he looks like he's glitched out. Oh, are you kidding me, man? Oh my gosh. I went in for the kill. I went in for the non-lethal, and he blasted me. I can't believe it, man. Oh. It was a good run, though. I had a lot better run that time than I usually do. Total criminal count, 51. I've seen worse. I've seen better, too. But catfish me, man. All right. I think that's good. It looks really good, Jeff. I think you've done a really good job so far, and I think we're all excited to keep seeing the progress on it. And I know I am, and I'm looking forward to working on it more. So I think it's going to be a lot of fun. But I'm going to load up Leventera and do some work on it so we can take a look at some of the other stuff we've got done here so far.
Have you pulled the most recent Rico?
I have not. I should do that.
Yeah, I'd like you to take a look at the banker.
I will take a look at the banker. This is all new to me, so I'm excited to see it. Where's Clay?
He said that he was feeling ill, so he'll be a little... I don't think he's going to make it.
I got you.
Taking a sick day.
Sick day?
How many of those do we allow?
How much sick leave do we have? I don't know. Giga Law Bath. Stomp your couch. Chancellor Firestar. Mostly us. I don't know who Chancellor Zero is. It's probably one of us still. I think we've all been talking to ourselves this whole time. Well, at least the record will still be there, like the archive for people that see it tomorrow. Some people actually do watch it. All right. What was I doing? Opening up Leventera. So what is it all in the, debug room? Is that where you're storing
all? Yeah, I set up a little expo there in the debug room, so you should be able to go in there and see it.
All right. Sounds good.
I changed his sprite to the apothecary. I don't know if you saw my screenshot there in Slack, but I screwed it up at first and changed his sprite to the portrait sprite.
Oh, I did see it.
Yeah, that's creepy.
Yeah, I saw it. I'm going to make sure here that the stream follows the new window creation here. If not, then I'll switch it over and so we can have something to look at.
Yeah, I don't see anything yet.
Yeah, I know. It's just been on black screen for a while. People are just now jumping in or like, what? What's going on? This stream sucks.
Now everybody knows the best streams are the black screens.
The what?
The best streams are just all black screen all the time.
Yeah, those are the best ones. Yeah, it looks like it's in. So, I'm gonna leave it here on the title screen real quick. Go take a bathroom break real quick, and then I'll check it out. All right? If you wanna hold over the, I'll be right back.
Yeah, me and Gary can provide color commentary for this title screen.
As you can see, how far are we behind? How far is this?
For me, it's been about 30 to 45 seconds.
We're about to see the MS trade wind crash into
Oh, does it crash into it on the title screen? I have not actually stared at the title screen that long in a long time.
Yeah. Wait, wait, wait.
The clouds are covering it up.
It's crashed.
Doesn't look very crashed.
It's crashed, man. It's not moving. I uploaded your avatar.
Oh, thank you very much. I'll fix that after we finish streaming.
Wait, do you want the big banner too, or just the avatar?
What's the banner for?
Someone goes to your profile.
Oh, okay. No, you don't have to worry about it right now. I mean, if you're ever making one for somebody else in the future, and you want one for me, that'd be cool. But
I mean, I have the PSD saved, so it's just like replace the text.
Alright, I mean, you can if you'd like.
And our names make
the next one.
Our names are all four letters long, so makes it pretty easy.
That helps a lot. Actually, just about everybody has a four letter name except for Will, who has a three letter name.
We'll just add on next show. I'm sure he's never had that before.
Is that here you guys talking about us all having four letter names?
Except yep. Will.
Oh, who has a three letter name? Hello, cool. Been a while.
Oh yeah, eat that banana. We're gonna have to get Twitch chat
not safe for work tag. I'm eating a banana.
All right. Sure. And not safe for work.
Okay. So here we are. Are you looking at the... I'm not actually streaming... I'm not sharing my screen this time, so... You're looking at the... You want me to do that for the Hangout? So you can see it live?
Sure. Yeah. It would help. So we can comment.
Okay.
Instead of 30 seconds in the past, or in the future.
Alright, Hangout guys, tell me if you got it live.
Yeah, it looks live to me, but you haven't moved, so I can't really tell.
Okay.
Yeah, it's definitely live.
So just pick up his money here?
You can if you'd like, or you can just talk. He now starts you out. You have a bank balance of 100 coins currently for testing purposes. Or
okay.
50 coins, sorry. And I realize that arrow kind of looks not good.
It's just a line.
It's,
oh my
it's
gosh,
actually,
dude.
It's actually Game Maker Studios draw arrow.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I figured we'll make a sprite or something.
Yeah, it'll be easy to make a sprite.
This layout is just something that I came up with, and I mean, I'm not sold on it or anything. It was the simplest way. I generally really hate the banking interfaces in most games.
So how do I finalize it then?
It's just, it's you're doing it live, essentially.
You're doing it live. Well, how do I, so, I mean, how do I just back out of it? Like,
Just hit control or whatever your return is, it'll back out.
Alright, cool, yeah, I'm using it. So, alright, cool.
And it should be, yeah, and it receives, I mean, you can look up in your HUD, and it reflects it immediately.
Yeah, I see it up there. We'll need to make it do, like, a little bit shorter repeat, I think.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, once a step, because it's like, I mean,
yeah,
I can't even get to the exact number.
A second, so. It operates every step, so when you're holding it in, it's moving 60 coins a second.
Alright, so let's bank all this money. Dude, we need to put this banker in the game, man.
Yeah,
pronto.
I mean, pretty much ready to go. I mean, it's everything I set up.
So now I try to buy goods. Can't do it, because I don't have money.
Yeah, I set up a new variable called bank account, and it's a global variable. It's declared just under money, so it...
Oh,
it's
man.
Effectively another variable identical to your money. What happened?
Dude, look at this glitch. Look at this glitch right here. See what happened? I set it all up. I'm supposed to take this much money away from me. I'm trying to make the deal. Airs out. Close out the window.
But it's real.
It's real, man.
Oh, that's funny.
It did it live. So I essentially just stole it all.
Your good spender is actually a word. He's like, that's essentially what my banker did just before we started streaming. The banker would essentially just allow you to overdraw your account until integer overflow.
Okay.
Just like the real world, to let you overdraw.
Yeah. Why? Well, hey, no, that gives me an idea. We could totally make a loan shark character. You have to pay him back interest. Otherwise, he'll start sending bounty hunters for you.
Well, it looks like we've got something I need to fix here. So let's pop on over to the Windows here. Whoa. I went to the future. You'll see it on the stream here in just a sec. Okay, and let's see. I want to fix that. I'd like to put the banker in the game somewhere, and I'd like to fix this trade goods guy here. If I can. So.
And to those of you in chat, feel free to contribute. You know, ask questions. Give feedback.
I think it's pretty much all us, but maybe there's a few. Yeah.
On the hope that there's somebody in there that's not us.
Somebody wants to ask a question but hasn't asked it yet.
Yeah, last time we had a fella that was like hosting us. And he was like, it was just him, but he kept asking questions. And
is there something you
find that guy? Call him up.
Is there something you have to do to send out notifications?
No, it does it on its own.
Okay.
Still interested in looking at that Pathfinder. I don't know what they're talking about. Okay, so it looks like it all calls from SCR Goods Vendor, but and see the problem here is that it looks like I have it set up to do it live. So if I back out of it, I need to find a way to reset it all to what it was. So I need to either assign local variables to all this stuff or something else. And then I can't believe I overlooked that until just now. So how can I do this, Nick? I mean, I need to take.
How set are you on having it be a transaction system where it's like you kind of set up your transaction and finalize it?
I mean, I really like it that way. I mean, we did a lot of different models to try and come up with it, and I think this is the most optimal one. But I'm thinking we can resolve it if we just like.
Yeah, just set up a bunch of dummy variables instead of using the real ones, and then whenever you finalize the deal, that's when you change the dummy variables back to zero. Well, you set the real variables equal to the dummy variables, and then you set the dummy variables back to zero.
Yeah.
I mean, that would essentially be how you would do it.
Yeah, that's true. So.
But yeah, you would need a dummy variable for every single
one of these, man. And then once it offloads to the quote, though, I mean, once it offloads to the script, then the dummy variables won't load anymore. You know?
What do you mean?
Okay, so I set all these dummy variables up here, and then once this runs, SCR Goods Vendor, it goes in here, it doesn't look for the local variables anymore.
Can't you use the with construction?
Yeah, you can, but it doesn't work for local variables. Like that's only for instance variables, so I'd have to like establish all the variables in the create event or wherever. Which I can do. But I mean,
I want to see what you mean, yeah.
There's gotta be a better way though. Maybe. I mean, I guess really all you need is 1, 2, 3, 12 variables.
Well, you could use another dummy variable in the script that's kind of like, it just says finalize the transaction, and whenever it's flipped on, the code that you want to run in and the object runs and then flips it back off, just to clear out. Just set up another dummy variable that says clear dummy variables, and you turn it on.
Yeah.
And when it's on, you know, OBJ Goods vendor checks for it, and when it is on, he clears the dummy variables and then turns it back off.
Hmm.
But that wouldn't help you in terms of getting the values from the dummy variables. You'd still have to set those equal to something that the script could reference. So yeah, no matter what, if you're going to want to use that script in order to pull values from those dummy variables, they're going to have to be declared.
Hmm. Yep.
Because no matter what, that script is going to have to pull the values for those dummy variables in one way, shape, or form.
Yeah. Either way, it'll have to do it. So I guess I might as well just establish variables for all of these then. I mean, I guess I could do. Everything you guys are typing in Slack is coming up on the stream, because it's popping up over the. Well,
tell them to turn your notifications off.
Yeah. The good thing is the total thing is already set up that way, so it creates the total variable. So what I need to do is set up the variables for this. So let me just leave this open over here. Yeah, I think what I'll need to do is, like, I mean, I do. I can't vape on screen. I can't eat chips on screen. What the hell can I do? Why am I doing this?
It's for the viewers, man. Wait, you stopped vaping on screen?
I'm eating marijuana chips. I'm not gonna stop vaping on screen. I got too much five pawns here. Five bongs, as they were calling it last week.
Whoa, we ain't paying them money, man. Careful with that product placement. Or they ain't paying us money.
No, I wish. Alright. Well, let's find this create code here for this then, and
I mean, you could just set it up as another array so that you only have to declare it once, and then.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. I mean. Well, let me just snap these two together then, and.
Wait. I don't always use Game Maker Studio, but when I do, I spend half my time just getting all my windows open.
Oh, I know, man. Well, what are these then, though? It looks like I've got these variables here set up already. Or it looks like I tried to at some point and I ended up abandoning it.
Oh, yeah. Merge coffee, sell coffee.
Yeah.
Oh, no, because that's how much the merchant has and how much. Oh, yeah, I guess what
but
is
that
sell?
Still would work, though.
The sell variable.
Yeah, and then you.
That's a 2D array. Oh, no, it just references the.
No, this is all right. So really what I need to do is set all this up here. Yeah. So, like, this one here is sell coffee plus equals one, or merch coffee.
Quick question.
Yeah.
Where's the cursor saved? Or is it a draw event or is it a sprite?
What cursor?
The triangle facing right.
The blinky arrow?
Oh, or it's a sprite. It's a sprite called SPR arrow.
Okay.
Okay. So the thing I'll need to update, though, is the draw event, because if I'm doing this and then having it all offload to it, you know, at the end.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you need to have it draw whichever the temp variable rather than the live one.
So really, I only need these variables, I think. Yeah, because then. Oh, man, you know what, though? I need a third variable, though, because when you close out, when you close out the window, you need to set these variables back to what they were when they started. You know? So
yeah, but that's why I said you could just set up a line of code in the goods vendor, so that whenever you close it out, it just automatically resets all the temps.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. But you have to reset it back to what it was when you started, and not.
Oh, you're talking about the ones that for his limited yeah. quantity.
Yeah, because he doesn't get recreated once you reset it like that.
Right.
Yeah, I think this is a problem for another time. Actually, I mean, I know how to fix it, but I'm not gonna mess with it right now. I'd rather put the banker in and put that to use, and see how it works. So, where can we put him? In the village?
Yeah, he'll need to go in the village somewhere.
And maybe build a new room.
Or
put him in this two-story.
Yeah, I was about to say, in terms of convenience, I think it would be better to have him open in the village. I mean, because, like I said, my idea for him...
No,
was
I mean, like, build a new building out here or something.
Oh, yeah, build like a little hut for him.
I mean, there's also this building with no door on it. You could put a little bank money sign on the side of it.
Yeah, I mean, that's essentially what you need. You just need a building like that and then draw some, you know, draw a gate or a barred, you know, cellar window or something there and put in behind it.
Yeah, I mean, this building is completely empty, so it'll be good to have a couple things in it, but...
And if you want to make it so that you can go in the building and do other stuff, like, that's fine, too. It's just, I definitely think the banker or a banker needs to be accessible from the outside because I think it's going to be something that the players are going to want to use a lot.
Oh, dude, I got an idea then. What we could do is just hollow this out and put like a little window where he's like standing there, you know, like a bank teller, the drive-through bank teller.
That's what I was saying. Like you put a window with the bank teller standing there, and then if you want to make so you can go in the building, that's fine too. But he definitely needs to be accessible from the outside.
All right. Well, I'm gonna move Jonathan over here then.
Is that gonna affect your story switch trigger?
I mean, yeah, it'll affect it in that. I'll have to walk this much further to trigger it.
Okay, so that's based on that object, though.
Yeah, it's based on that object.
Okay.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. So, let's see here.
For those of you that don't know, whenever you walk past Jonathan for the very first time, he, you know, stops you for a cutscene and does the whole catching you up on what's been going on.
Yeah, we'll illustrate it here in just a second. So, basically, I could just take this... like one of these desks or something. See, this is at layer 5, so the banker will need to be at the layer below that. So is there anything I have to set up for the banker as far as creation code?
No, actually, I made him completely creation code independent, I believe.
Okay.
You obviously can use instance specific code to mess with stuff if you'd like.
Okay, but he has no. He starts with no money, right?
No, by default, he starts your account with 50, just kind of as a temporary setup.
Okay, and we don't have a whole lot of portraits right now, so I'm just going to leave his portrait default, which is, I think, the apothecary guy, right?
Yeah, it'll make him the apothecary guy right now in the object creation code.
Also, I should make another layer and put a wall, I guess, on the back of this for background, or just leave it at sky. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it should be wall. I mean,
all right. Depth 7. And let's just get some building stuff.
You know, we can have somebody make a stack of coins or something.
Yeah. I don't like that one for that. There's that.
Just have the whole building made out
of gold. I don't know. It probably won't look good either way, but we'll just go with it for now. I just want to test it out. I also kind of wanted to stretch my legs on this new save load system a little bit too, so. Enjoy the crunch.
You can set up a threshold for your mic so we don't have to hear your eating.
Oh. I won't do it. I won't do it long. Okay, wait. Okay. So I'm just gonna start a new game then, and and just work my way up to it, because I want to test the save load stuff, so.
Yeah, that'll be good, because you'll actually have a good amount of money now.
Yeah,
whenever you
pick up some cash, bank it, go, die, and then it should still all be there, right?
Yeah, actually, it should. You know, I didn't even think about that, but...
That's the point.
That was the point. Works as intended.
Yeah, we're about to find out, so... Nice game, thank you. We've been working on it since February. It's gonna hit Kickstarter August 22nd. Website's got more info. Should be going through the green light process about the same time. Gonna be some cool reward tiers and stuff like that. Appreciate the props though. Just working on it right now, adding some new features. Alright, let's see here. If I full screen this, you still get... Yeah, okay. The frame rate's a lot better on full screen, so... Let's go ahead and do that.
We lose the live feed, though.
You lose the... Oh, on...
I don't know if it's going to be as big of a deal right now if you're not working on code.
It starts with 50 in the bank. You get 50
in
the bank.
Yeah, that's just temporary for testing purposes.
Okay.
At launch, you know, the banker's not going to be as generous.
it's actually not bad. I mean, it kind of, you know, it looks like what it's supposed to be. I mean, a dude behind the desk in a building with the door cut open, like a little window. I mean, it does appear to be that way.
Yeah, I think he needs some bars or something.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely needs something.
Maybe put another sentry out there just so it looks like he's protected. Needs some tweaking, but... Alright, so you banked everything?
Yeah, I banked it all. Now I'm going through Jonathan's little spiel. I actually like it better, him being back this far, too, because then you, like, watch him walk away for a while. It gives you a chance to, like, catch up with him and hear him say that, you know, so that you can... Because surely, you know, you see him walking away real slow, it seems like you'd be like, oh, I wonder if he has anything else to say, you know, maybe. But if you don't see it, it's not the end of the world. Alright, my next mission is to die. And then go back to the bank, see if my money's still there.
I think we determined earlier that you can't die when you're in the village.
No, you can't die when you're in the village.
I'm sure that some testers, once we get into Alpha, will prove us wrong.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm interested to see how they come up with that one, too. I don't even know how this part is doable without the boomerang, man.
If your objective is to die, you're not doing a very good job.
Oh, I know. I'm just playing through it. Just trying to enjoy it a little bit. I don't get to do this ever, man. I'm usually just, like, kind of grinding out one piece.
Can you slice your own boomerang?
Say again?
Can you slice your own boomerang?
No, you can't.
In fact, I was actually thinking the other day about making a change to the boomerang that would make it a little easier to hold on to it. My idea was to have it, when you throw it, whenever it reaches its final point away from you, it's going to start back towards you on a trajectory that's, you know, actually towards the player rather than just opposite of the direction it's going. So if you jump up and throw it, it'll come back at you at a downward angle rather than fly right over your head.
Yeah, I mentioned that the last stream session too. We were talking about possibly making an upgrade or making a stock, and then we hadn't really decided on it, because a lot of people have kind of complained about that.
And myself being the loudest of the complainers.
Yeah, I mean, it's understandable. It's a real pain in the ass when you lose it, you know what I mean? But it also doesn't cause any... It doesn't cost any Leventera to use either, so it's kind of like... You know.
Yeah, it's a free-range weapon of sorts. But when you lose it, oh boy, does it hurt.
It does, man. It really stings.
This is such an unforgiving part of it.
Yeah, it is. Like this...
Oh. If Clay was on, I don't know if I would congratulate him or scold him for making it that difficult.
Oh yeah, I know. It's just such a fine balance between the two. Hey, I got the lumberjack doing his attack again.
So is that cable supposed to be that color?
No. No, that's I haven't changed the asset back over yet. You can pretty much just spam these guys to death now. Maybe it's too long.
Hey, what's that little pile in the water there? Is that just like a...
It's supposed to be a rock.
Okay.
But it apparently needs to be...
Swamp pie.
Revamped.
It looks like a little pile of ash or something. Or clay, yeah. Maybe. It
looks like something you'd want to interact with, I guess.
Really? It just looks like a gray loaf of bread.
Now that he does his attack, he's a little bit more challenging now. Quite a bit more, I would say. He's going to be doing the dash and back dash too, though.
So what you're saying is you're screwed.
Maybe. I'm not going to have any money in the bank at this point. Or actually, if it works the way it's supposed to, it's a good thing I did make my money so I can get it back out. Oh man, he gets me when I'm crouched still.
It's like that Castlevania boss. It's just a completely unavoidable boss hit.
Which one?
No, the last boss in one of the I think it might have been Simon's Quest or no, it might have been Castlevania.
Oh yeah, no, Castlevania 3, I think.
Yeah, and he shoots those flames up on both sides and on both sides of you, and there's no dodging it if you don't have enough health at that point in the game to survive that hit.
No chance whatsoever.
Because even on the most perfect and tool-assisted speedrun you can imagine, it's unavoidable. You have to take it at least once, and it's like 40% of your health.
Okay, I'm gonna run back to the bank, see if I have any cash in there. Since I've died. Kind of a long trek back to the bank from here.
I've told you that before.
Oh, I know, but there's a fast travel location I can get to. Well, it doesn't do me any good for getting back to the bank now, but...
Yeah. We might need to add one. I don't know how feasible it would be in terms of the world we
set
up.
Well, the pier. The pier is going to have one.
Yeah, but I mean around the pier is definitely going to have one, but around the lumberjack as well.
Wah, wah, wah.
Because you've got the grotto right after. Oh yeah, I know why that is. That's because the creation code of the banker is to set your bank account equal to 50.
Can I fix it?
Yeah, I can show you exactly where to fix that.
All right, well, let's do it then. Let me switch the scene back over.
Yeah, you're just gonna want to go into OBJ banker.
All right.
And
Let me grab Google Keep real quick and note on here so I don't forget.
I believe we lost our one viewer who wasn't us.
Oh really?
Yeah.
That's all good. I'll be in and out probably.
Yeah, you might want to set up just at least one art checkpoint for the banker, because now that he's functional, he'll need at the very least a sprite and a portrait.
Yep. There we go. I will go ahead and put in art request too.
It might seem like that art request log is a lot longer than the code request log, but the time it takes to make one check in the code request, yeah. The artist can do about every single one of those art requests.
They can, man. They really can. It's not even on the same level, man. Like how quickly they can knock it out. What is the where am I going here?
Oh yeah, sorry. It's objects, OBJ NPCs, OBJ banker. And then his creation code has it's set temporary, remember to remove. You can just delete it. I guess if you want to make, I can't think of a decent way to make the bank account, unless you can think of code that runs it, that only runs once at the creation of the game. I can't think of a way to set the bank account to have a stock value and it not get reset somewhere.
I mean, you set it to zero, right? I mean. Yeah, that's the way you do it. You just set a global variable.
It's defined. If you want it to just be zero, then just delete what you've got there, and it should. Well, actually, it's gonna.
Does it call on it though? I mean, that's the thing. If it calls on it, then.
Yeah, it calls on it. It defines it as a global variable, but it doesn't give it any value.
Yeah, so bank account plus equals one. So, wait, where is it defined as a global variable?
In OBJ display, but you can't. You still can't really.
All right. Well, if it defines it there when you start the game, then we'll just define it as zero. But I see what you're saying, though. You'll have to save it.
Every time you restart the game, it's going to reset it to zero.
Well, yeah. Unless you just put it in your save data, right? Which should be fine. We can do that real quick. Because I'm going to test out the load function anyway. So where does it put it in? Just in create a global var bank account. Yeah.
It's at the very top.
Yeah, so is it, you said it's global?
It's global. It's at just, the very top of OBJ display, create, yeah.
Yeah, I see it here, but it doesn't give it a value ever, right?
No, it doesn't. Okay. Yeah, I don't know how you handle that with saving and loading. So.
Well, I can do that right here. What's it called, bank account?
Yep.
This is for loading. So load game won't work now after I do this.
Again.
Alright. Then I need to find the else statement for it. And then put it down here. Bank account equals zero. And then for OBJ jump, I need to save that data. Oh, sorry, it's an SCR save game. Where is it? Hero functions. There we go. I will need to just do save vars bank account. All right. So now we'll test it. I'm just going to test it proper. Like, I'm just going to run through. I'm not going to play a bunch of game and stuff. I'm just going to run through, try it, die, try the bank again, quit the game, load the game.
Yes. Yeah, on a regular playthrough, it'll be fine because you'll have money to bank as soon as you get to them, so. Unless you really died a lot. I've got to set that up so that you can type that into the keyboard directly.
What?
I still want to set up the text input so that you can type your characters into the keyboard directly. Yeah. Hey, pull your mic back down.
My bad.
Yeah. I mean, even if you're playing with a controller, you know, I mean, even when I play games with a controller, if anything prompts me for text, I immediately go to the keyboard.
Yeah. I mean, it makes sense if you're, you know, sitting right there at it.
Yeah. Because no matter how good you make your controller keyboard input, it's just never good.
And it's never as good as a keyboard. Straight typing. I don't have an eye on the chat window or anything, so hopefully nobody's been.
I'm watching it.
Nothing.
Crickets.
Yeah, we did a little bit better last week, but that's understandable, though. I mean, we had somebody else that was hosting us, too, so kind of helped along a little bit. Alright, 17-0, didn't get a game in and crash. Still in there. So should go back, die, draw. Actually, let's just try to go back into the room after creation. There should be, what, 17 coins in there?
Yes, that's what you put in.
Yep, there they are. Still in there, clear as day. Just take out two. Man, this will be huge for, like, saving up for the big weapons and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, I mean, you're gonna have to use this. I mean, if death is gonna be lose half your money, you gotta have a way to store it.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back to the bank, check to see if my remaining 15 are in there, and actually bank the rest of what I got now. Quit the game, load the game, and make sure all of it's saved. Did you notice my little debugger in the inventory window to show the date and time?
Oh, yes.
So I did that so I could test out the world map view stuff.
Really, we gotta add that. We gotta add functionality similar to that to the DevCon so that whenever you bring it up, it displays whatever information you want it to.
Yeah, that would be better, actually, just to show it on the DevCon instead of.
Yeah, because the DevCon, like, the right side of it is almost never utilized anyway.
Yep. Whoa. That crab just disappeared, dude. That was weird, man. I've never seen that bug before.
You hit him so hard.
No, I mean, I didn't hit him. He just disappeared.
Oh, that crab.
Yeah, you guys are probably seeing the disappearing stuff because of the flash effect. But there was one crab that just walked into the wall and just totally disappeared.
Nah, yeah, I saw it. I saw the one you were talking about there. You didn't even hit him. He was just... That's going to take forever to track down.
Yeah. Alright, 15 still in there. We'll bank the rest of it. Okay, so remember that. 34. Jonathan, I don't want to talk to you right now.
You made him. Unskippable cutscene.
Okay. Alright, I'm going to quit the game. Then I'm going to restart the game.
Gotta love that
mini off ID. Wait, why am I not? Am I that far behind? Oh, there it is. Okay. Seem to load. Oh, yes. Well done, sir. 34 in the bank. Still loaded properly and everything.
Nice.
Congrats, man. That's a good function. That's a good function. Quick turnaround on that.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, I've had in my head what I wanted it to be for a while. It was just kind of can get that on paper. And obviously, you're going to want to go in and move stuff around. I mean, in terms of visuals, do whatever you want. I'm not hard set on any of that, obviously. But in terms of the functionality, like, I kind of like that a lot more than, you know.
I think what we'll do is...
or whatever.
Say again, Gary?
I didn't say anything.
Oh.
I think I moved my mic from the top of my head to in front of my mouth.
Say what?
I just moved my mic down.
What I'm thinking is we'll do is we'll probably make a special window for this. Like, a smaller one. Since we have all this black space here.
Yeah.
And then, you know, maybe just put, like, one box on one side and one box on the other. And then use the big coin icon for the coins and the chest
on the other
side.
I'm thinking, honestly, like, with this battle, what I'm thinking about doing is going in and just kind of adding a timer with acceleration to the deposit and withdrawal function, so that as you hold right or left, it goes faster as time moves on. So
yeah.
it shouldn't take more than a few seconds to deposit all your coins, unless you have just a stupid amount.
I think that's a good idea. I think that's.
And then if I do that, then I won't have to add a button to deposit all or whatever. I mean, it's just at the speed that it's moving now, even if I slow it down a little bit, you shouldn't need a deposit all button. So
yeah. No, I like the plan. I think it's good.
Yeah, and that'll allow you to just kind of hold it in to get close to where you're wanting, and then use, you know, precise taps and whatnot to get it exactly where you want.
Have you guys seen the Foreman boss since I beefed him up a little bit?
I haven't seen him in a long time.
Alright. I'll go fight him then. Actually, I'll just go through the whole... Now that I've got a loading game that works properly... Like, I was thinking about nerfing the axe just a little bit, but you're gonna want something that hits hard against that Foreman fight, I think. Oh, mother effort. That's something we gotta give. We gotta, like, work on that a little bit, too. Like, if you're, like, all the way through your apogee... Man, on your jump, it kills your horizontal speed when you attack. So it's because of this, so that when you're walking, we need to make it so that it only kills your horizontal speed when you're on the ground, you know? Anybody disagree with that?
No.
Yeah, because I think that's definitely a big pain, like, bug. It's like construed as a bug. I think it should be treated as a bug because it's so broken.
Yeah, I agree.
These wolves are broken too, man.
Who broke those?
Was that you?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just standing there now. I'm gonna vape. Anybody who disagrees can kiss my butt.
We should make the stars.
We should what?
We should make the stars a little bit of a Parallax.
Just a little bit. They should be where they are, though. They're billions of miles away.
I mean, it'll just give it a different feel. And are they billions of miles away?
I think so. Even in Sarawin. I'm not seeing anything that's going on in Slack. So if it's important, let me know.
We just kicked you out.
Oh, mutiny? What is this, a mutiny? Oh my god, dude. Oh, I forgot about the boomerang, man. Lifesaver. A statute of limitations on the vaping, like after 10 p.m. or something like that. should be the time that I'm allowed to do it.
Honestly, as long as the stream's not huge, I don't think it's a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, if we've got 13 people in here that aren't even talking or something, I think it's fine. But...
especially if 12 of them is us.
Yeah, 12 of them are us, yeah. I gotta get to the foreman. I beefed him up a little bit. Made him a little bit more of a challenge.
Although I think Dank Meme Master 420 probably approves.
Dank Meme Master 420. Is he here? Dank Meme Master 420.
I like that.
Spiders.
You gotta have big spiders in an RPG, it's like a given. You know what we don't have that is also an RPG necessity? That is giant rats.
Giant rats are coming, dude. They're gonna be in the cave.
You gotta have a guy that gives you a quest at the very beginning. Even if we don't have quests in the rest of the game, there's gotta be a whole quest system developed just so we can have one quest that'll kill 10 giant rats.
Yep. I mean, that's gonna be something interesting, you know, that we really haven't done yet. Is
inside quests.
Basic quest structure. I mean, we're totally set up for it. You know. So could be really cool. Notice it broke into a we got goblins. Yeah.
Dude, that is... I saw the one... Those pickaxe throws are unforgiving.
Yeah, dude, it's good, man. It makes it a little bit... Because this area needed something really bad. Now, dude, this is where it gets difficult, man. Because now that he has this spinning pickaxe of death, you gotta dodge all that stuff, too. And then...
You know...
What?
Oh, I was saying the green dudes. It's interesting because on the stream they might kind of blend into the background, but it would actually be cool if we made an enemy in the cave or something that was like a rock person that intentionally like blended in.
Oh yeah, and it pops out at you maybe.
That yeah, cool. Or like it doesn't move until you're like right up on it.
Oh yeah, dude, that's kind of a classic thing, but yeah, that's a good idea, I think. It went off screen, man. Big Axe went off screen and stayed. It's gone. The green thing is a pickaxe, and it's gonna have like a little effect sprite on it that like insinuates that it's enchanted in some way or controlled by the eye. So I had the boomerang, picked up this one. This one costs lev orbs, but it's a little bit better. It's like a... And I also dropped my two-handed axe for the pickaxe. And something that we haven't really addressed... Oh, the green circle, the eyeball? Yeah. Yeah, Illuminati confirmed. Yeah, I think that we're trying to, like, we're going to discuss, like, the way that the eyeball is, like, part of the whole corrupting evil, I guess, of this area. So it's gonna tie back into the story here somehow, but we haven't really figured that out yet. But But what I was going to mention while I'm in here is that all three of these weapons that are lying on the ground now are going to be bereft once I leave and come back. Like, and I don't know if that's something that we want to deal with, but right now, it's, you know, that's the way it is. So, I don't know. It's a design choice. You know, we'll have to discuss that. But now that I have the pickaxe, a couple things that I can do. There's Blackjack, so he can take me back to the ship or wherever. Which we'll come back around to that later. But these little iron nodes that we had up here, I can mine those now. See it then, but yeah, you can't climb the ladders unless you have, if you've got, unless your hands are free. Oh man, I'll need to fix that.
Hit the grotto and fast travel to the pier, but I forgot the pier doesn't connect.
The pier doesn't exist yet. I mean, we can make it be. I mean, it actually does exist, it just doesn't. Ah, we need that so bad right now. The pier area.
There's right
now
the
I have to walk all the way back to the village from here, but I'll just
go. You can go to the beach, at least. I mean, the beach is only one zone away.
What's that?
The beach is only one zone away.
Yeah. Ah! Oh my gosh. No, those weren't leaves. They were like little green, emerald-colored mine nodes. Crystals. They're like little green crystals.
Green-colored mine node crystals.
Ah, that sucks so bad. I lost half of that cash that I had. Just trying to get back to the bank to store it. It's gonna be an interesting challenge, though, because you're gonna wanna do that at times. Like, you're gonna wanna, like, abandon your current, you know, quest path, or whatever it is, so that you can go and bank your stuff.
Also, in the future, when you can fast travel to your boat and have a banker on your boat, this won't be as frustrating.
Yeah, see, I'm thinking that needs to be crew upgrade type material, you know?
Oh, like, almost certainly. Like, you don't want to start with a banker.
Yeah. You find it.
Cost, I mean, master coin like 1,000 like coins to hire a banker to get your boat.
I need to make it so that once you've gained lab orbs once, the enemies sometimes drop them. Because, like, as it is right now, nothing game drops level orbs at this point, so it's like, this weapon I have is essentially useless.
Well, I mean, you could developer console yourself some.
Oh, of course I could. Look at that, man. Bank that money. Yeah, so we need the pier. We need to do the pier somehow. I don't know. I guess we could do it on a parallax layer or something. I don't know if we want to draw something that extends, like, back here.
Yeah, I mean, I think it should definitely be visible from here as more than just a gate. I mean, you can draw it kind of small in the distance if you'd like.
What do you think? Is Will or Jeff here?
Will is for sure. I don't know. I think Jeff had to go.
What do you guys think, artistically, we could do to get the pier, like, into this section right here? Because I'm thinking, like, between these two trees, it'd be good to have something that, like, a door, at least a door you walk into to go to the pier area, where there'll be another fast travel node, and ask him to think it over. Oh, I wasted the thrown pickaxe on a sheep, man. Now I'm without. I need to finish respriting the girl character so that you can actually play as her. Pick stayed in there. Oh, whoops. Well, there's a problem.
You know, we might want to consider adding, like, rather than having Lev Orbs drop off of enemies and such, maybe add, like...
Oh, we're like, playing the game and then working on some of the bugs and problems that we have, so kind of going back and forth.
We go in and out. It's
HTML, CSS, 404, 4014. We're kind of, like, just ironing out some of the bugs and so we're developing and testing at the same time. Is he gone? He left, didn't he?
Yeah, I guess so. I don't know.
So if you have the resources and you try to buy it, he does say the tools will cost us instead of I need resources to make repairs, so that's good at least. This is all in Game Maker Studio, so we're just using GML. But we're about to take a look at some, because I've got, well, not going to look at the code, actually, because I have this one thing here that wasn't set as visible to false, so I'm going to pop out and fix that problem real quick. But first, oh, God.
What did you do?
I don't know. Destroy it. It is a C++-based language. If I'm not mistaken, it compiles to C++. We'll take a look at it in a second. I'm going to pull up something. I had a game ending crash here. Moose feed equals 4 plus hole, variable get 5 hole on object ship.
Yeah, the Visual Studio compiles and writes everything in C++, but the actual language in itself that you write into it is more like Java.
Yeah, it's a proprietary language that they wrote, but it's very similar to JavaScript. So a couple things here. I wanted to look at RMShip to fix that one issue. And my son is crying, so I will be right back. Tile layer 2 needs to start out invisible here. So it should be in the creation code here. Yeah. So we'll just go ahead and...
Yeah, HTML, CSS. We could have done this game in C easily. It would have been overkill. I mean, it is a bit more than we need. And since we have some people working on this project with us that aren't proficient in any language really in terms of coding, and Game Maker Studio allows them to contribute without actually knowing any code.
But also, I mean, the suite itself of software is really set up to play into this type of game that we're making here. I mean, it works really well for this 2D platformer type thing. There's a lot of tools built into it to help us out. So, I mean, there have been a couple places where it's limited us a little bit, but I think it's definitely helped us a lot more than it's hurt us, especially for turnaround time. So, yeah, it's a good point that you bring up, for sure.
Yeah, from a code standpoint, we're always going to look at it at times and say, oh, man, if we were writing this in C, I could do this in 2 seconds. But I have to do a workaround that takes an hour, you know, and that's going to happen. But like I said, it allows us to it allows us to streamline a lot of other stuff that would take us a lot longer if we weren't using Game Maker Studio. So.
I will be right back. I gotta grab Felix real quick. I'll be right back.
Sure. Gary, are you still there?
Actually, not yet. That's the goal here. Right now, I work at a place selling X-ray equipment, so this is a means to an end here. We're going to be launching a Kickstarter August 22nd, and for this project, and we're trying to get it off the ground big enough that hopefully we can. Make a profession out of it for some of us at least. So, all right. So I wanted to take a look at this here. Yeah, I'd like to see. Are you working on a game, or doing web stuff, or?
What wasn't that wasn't layered correctly? I don't think I saw it.
It was layer 2 in OBJ ship. It was layered correctly. It just wasn't. It's supposed to be hidden when you enter the room. So that was a problem. And also, this event here is calling on this. If you see this whole variable everywhere, it needs to be self whole because that's a global variable. Very nice. Best of luck to you, man. That's glad to see people, you know, making a living out of making the internet a better place, helping out other businesses and stuff like that. It's good.
Yeah, we've been trying to do that as we've been been available.
Yep, definitely good to start young. So you can be disappointed a bunch of times before you really hit it big. But I mean, it sounds like you got it all figured out, man. So hope you're really successful. It looks like that's the only place that references it. Self hole, -20. I think I got it covered. Just that one broken variable there. Wow, man. That is young. So you're doing pretty good then. Got a business at 16. Started at 12. It's a pretty good success story. Okay, popping back over to the game view. See if I fix the problem here. Now I'm curious to see. I think if I load game at this point, since it only saves when you go to. It only saves when you hit OBJ jump, so should be fine. Go back to load game. Yeah, I think that I just this is where I was last. Okay, so it looks like the tile layer part did what it's supposed to do. Climb up in there. So eventually the idea here is that this hold will fill up with your crates of your trade goods, which a lot of you guys didn't see the trade goods vendor, because I haven't actually placed them anywhere because we didn't do the pier room yet. But as you buy trade goods, this area here will fill up with crates. Man, I need to make that to where he hits his head on the ceiling instead of flipping through.
Yeah, that sounds like an idea. I'm thinking maybe make it so that in order to buy the crate to put on your ship to store your resources, you have to like collect so many of them.
Yeah.
Or, well, I guess since you can only hold 12, you know, maybe make it so that the crate costs 10 or whatever.
Well, I mean, you can only hold 12. It'd be cool to make them destructible, you know, by enemies or something like that, but I feel like if you saw a bunch of crates down here and you went down in here, just like the first thing you'd do is you'd be like brum, 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 and just break all of them. So I'm thinking that once we get to the skirmish module, so you can actually run into these other ships and do ship to ship. Are you kidding me, man? Alright.
Hull move speed.
Move speed equals 0.4 plus hull. It still says execution here, very good hull from OBJ ship, not from enemy ship. Yeah, I like the idea though there, HTML CSS 0414, of we're gonna build a skirmish module so that the other enemies can board your ship once you run into them. And you know, from there, we're thinking maybe the crates are destructible by enemies, and that would be, you know, a way to go. And you could catch fire, like you said, that'd be a really neat thing to do. But we were talking about the idea of making them destructible by yourself too, and I think it might be a little bit too brutal on the player if you. Because you buy all these goods and then you see them in your ship, it's like, oh, that's neat. I feel like the player would have a propensity to just, like, attack the crate because that's what he's done up to this point. And it would destroy it, and I think everybody would be disappointed. So, kind of like a turning friendly fire off thing, I think. I don't know. I mean, it's definitely not decided, but I think it would be a little bit harsh to introduce that way. I mean, yeah, you could do it as a setting. There aren't really any yet, but we don't have a lot of things to set. Difficulty level and stuff is kind of later in development. We're still very early phases here, so there's not a whole lot of stuff to set.
The difficulty level's on the radar for sure. Graphical settings are going to be a thing for sure, but we've really got to optimize our graphics before we can... Yeah, I mean, it's just something that we haven't... the audio settings, actually, you can change them in the game using our built-in developer console, but there's not, like, a menu setting for them yet. But in terms of video settings, we've just got to optimize our video. We've got to optimize our graphics before we can actually mess with those at all. Because currently, if you're playing on a substandard rig, it's there are issues, and we're working on tracking them down, but it's problematic.
Well, this is our bugger right here in code, is hull, but trying to figure out where it's all, why it's not finding that variable, because it should be a defined global variable somewhere, or maybe I defined it, but I never actually gave it a value, you know? That's probably what happened. But you know, I didn't set all of those values to save either. So interested to see. Interested to see how that comes about.
Oh, it crashed looking for move speed. Which objects?
No, it crashed looking for hull. It's setting move speed to hull times 0.4. So if your hull is your hull is damaged, then it slows you down. So, but it's
wait,
fine.
Why would it be doing that when you weren't at the travel screen?
Say what now?
Why would it even be looking for that if you weren't at the travel screen?
I was. I was trying to get into the travel screen.
Oh, I see.
Huh. Yeah, I don't know, man. We probably talk about it sometime in private, I would say. Would probably be the best way. I'm not even seeing where these variables are coming from, so I don't really remember where I set them up, because it's not in the create event here. So I must have set the globals at some point. And I know that they're called on an OBJ display in this draw event. So maybe they're set in the draw event here. Because, nope, there it is. Cannonballs, hole, and food. They have to have been set at some point before that.
Well, maybe that's just it. If it's not set, then
yeah, I mean, it definitely
causing your crash.
It definitely wouldn't find it if it's not set. I mean, that's for sure. But the other two seem to be set, or maybe they're not. Maybe I never set them to begin with. That's probably the thing. So I'll just set them. I'll set them all here in the creation code. And, you know, I guess I might as well tie them to the save system, too, while I'm at it. Since we're wanting to see some dev here. We've got a little debug room, and GameMaker Studio has a debugger built into it. So, yeah, I mean, I could definitely run the debugger and see if my variables are set right away. So it'd probably be good, but then I just have to, like, compile the game and get to that point in the game again. Which, you know, we already know that they're not set properly, so there's no sense really in running the debugger at this point, I don't think, at least. So I'll just go in and just define all these variables here, add them to the save load system, and it's very similar. I mean, I can show it to you. I mean, I'll just run the game with the debugger going at the same time after I define these variables here.
Yeah, it's pretty nice, actually. It's a whole standalone debugger. From what I hear, GameMaker Studio's debugger used to be pretty crappy, and they've fairly recently, before we started using it, revamped it, and I've been happy with it so far. I definitely could not make anything without it. I use it. John doesn't use it quite as much as I do because, you know, he does more visual and design stuff, but when you're making, you know, I suppose I'm trying to think of the right way to word this. When you're trying to make stuff interact with the other objects in the game, like it's really helpful to have the debugger because it's pretty comprehensive.
I'm thinking maybe just start us with 50 cannonballs to begin with, and then 100 hole, of course. And then now the interesting thing is that when you I've got it set now so that the script only runs when you hit OBJ jump. But if you quit the game and then reload the game, it's basically, you know, it will not have saved unless we tell this SCR save game to run another time, you know, like maybe when you take the wheel. What do you think?
Save the game when you take the wheel?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually. I mean, especially if you're going to want to make it so that we can collect resources and
yeah.
While you're traveling, then that's definitely going to need to be a thing.
Yeah, I think so too. So let's just go ahead and add that then. Cannonballs.
GameMaker Studio actually allows us to export it directly as an EXE, and then we can use that to distribute it internally. Since it's 8-bit, you know, 2D, an installer is not really necessary because ridiculously small.
GameMaker Studio lets you export an installer as well, so it just compiles an installer in C. So,
given the size of the game, it wouldn't be necessary. But
probably not. I mean, at this point, definitely not. But maybe down the line. I mean, if there's a lot of audio.
Yeah. But our ultimate end game here is distribution on Steam, so an installer won't be as necessary.
Well, so here's the thing that's going to suck. Oh, crap, I was going to run it in the debugger. Sorry about that. If I try to load the game at this point, it's going to totally crap all over me. So said I was going to load the debugger. It was just, well, what the heck? It didn't.
It didn't grab hold of me. That's not a good sign, really. You expected it to break and it didn't. Usually the other way around.
Yeah. Yeah. Most usually it is. I'm going to switch back to this for full screen so I can get the better frame rate on the stream. Okay. There's my undefined value it gives me. So before it couldn't find the variable. Now it's giving me undefined value, so that's good. So here's the debugger, so you want to know.
Yeah, distributing our own website is also another avenue that we're looking at. I mean, for some of our other projects, even for this game.
Yeah, I don't think that there's any ramifications for doing it both ways.
Well, you get 100% of the revenue if we distribute ourselves. But
no, I know, but I mean, I don't think there's any...
We lose the customers that we would otherwise...
I don't think there's any violation in Steam's contract for distributing it on your own website as well.
No, they don't care.
Yeah. Here's the little developer console that we built, too. Just to get around a little bit more, you can kind of work back and forth. There we go. Now we're talking. Okay, so my ship variable saved. I mean, a lot of folks are going mobile for that reason, because they just want to, you know, you can increase your margins that way, and it's, I mean, the other day I was at this event, and I heard a bunch of people that were in their 50s and 60s talking about the games they were playing on mobile, and I was like, are you kidding me? I mean, yeah, you can. Right now I can't, because it's not fixed, but we can resolve that. I could spawn myself all the material to fix this thing, or I can just use the DevCon and just do ship fixed, and then should be able to drive it now. So the coolest thing, I think, about the boat travel aspect of it is that we've got this naval combat module that we're working on here. Oh, my food. Dude, my food's decreasing.
Were you able to move? Oh, okay, you've got two at least.
Well, I'm down to -3, so I guess it's still... Dude, this guy's got like infinite hole too. The lighthouses, they follow you right now, so no, they don't really do anything. But
Oh, you're going so slow.
What's that?
You were going so slow there at the end.
Oh, I know, it's just dragging along. I wrote in a module too to like for these parallax backgrounds here, like this one that shows the first person, probably not, no. But you can go into this though, like this is the whole idea, that you'll have a skirmish, like if you run into another ship, you'll have a skirmish mode, so you'll come here, there'll be another ship like in the background, and then you can jump from it, this platform, up to the ship on their platform, and then this foreground ship will just disappear entirely. So you'll be on their ship, and you'll fight like a little combat, you'll run through here, there'll be some enemies pop out.
We've got quite a bit of weapons in the game as it is HTML, but we're definitely planning to have a lot more. I mean, it's not quite like an ARPG level of, you know, sword plus one strength, you know, randomized loot. But we are planning a variety of weapons.
Capturing other ships, I mean, that's something that we've entertained before, but I think that we're probably going to stay away from it, because I think the story of the game is going to be around this ship kind of being a special thing. So the MS Tradewind is going to be, like, really integral to the story of the game, I think. So capturing other ships may be a thing. It might be